This screencast is going to be about energy balances. And energy balances are similar to material balances since both mass and energy are conserved. In fact, if you take a look at the first law of thermodynamics, it states that energy can be neither created nor destroyed. Probably the best way to state this is that accumulation equals input minus output. We've seen a similar balance when we've talked about material balances. However, there is no consumption or generation terms. Why is that? Because, again, energy can be neither destroyed nor created. So let's look at three types of energy in the total energy of the system. And those three types are kinetic, potential, and internal. So if we start with kinetic energy, that's the energy of motion. So we call this E sub k, and this is 1/2 times the mass or mass flow rate times the velocity squared. And sometimes you'll see instead of V, you'll see in a U. Potential energy is the energy caused by a change in elevation. So we write this as mgz, where m again is the mass or mass flow rate, g is the gravitational acceleration, and z is the height of the object or fluid above the reference height. So the third type of energy that we look at is what's known as internal energy. And this is often described as all the other energy. And what it is it's due to molecular interactions. So these are things like rotational, translational motion, electromagnet interactions. We call this internal energy U. In addition, we have heat, so that's Q. And what that is energy that's transferred due to a temperature difference. Now, this is between the system and the surroundings. So, for example, you have a reactor, and the air around it is 25 degrees C. A reaction takes place, and the products are at 500 degrees C. What will happen is that heat will flow from the system to the surroundings since there is a temperature difference. So Q is considered positive when it's transferred to the system from the surroundings. So in this case, is the Q negative or positive? Let's take a look. The system is at 500 degrees. The surroundings is at 25 degrees. It is transferred from the system to the surroundings, so our Q will be negative. We also have work, which is a form of energy. And what this is a response to any other driving force other than temperature. So this can encompass a number of things, such as pistons, pumps, turbines, and there's a difference of opinion on how to describe the sign of work. So in Felder and Rousseau, it's defined that work is positive when it's done by the system on the surroundings. However, in other textbooks, including thermodynamic ones, it's the opposite, that work is negative when the system does work on the surroundings. And you might wonder how the two can reconcile. And you'll see in a future screencast when we talk about the equation for the energy balance, you'll see how it does end up being reconciled. So these are the important elements of starting energy balances. If we look at the types of energy, kinetic, potential, and internal, as well as the heat and work, we're going to use these definitions to determine the amount of all these particular energies.